Hello, this is Anya with elementaltherapy.org, and today we will dive deep into Swadhisthana Chakra. Swadhisthana is located directly above Mulatara, or the Earth Center, and it's located below navel, about four fingers below navel, so it's in the lower, in the middle of the lower belly. And it's represents water energy. It's a water energy in our body and our being. And just like the oceans are supported by the floor and stability of the ocean floor, that earth and rivers flow in the banks that's formed from in the earth, so is Swadhisthana is supported by their Mulatara, by the earth center. But it's very liquid, it's very playful, it's flowing, it's connected with creativity, the procreation and co-creation, sexuality, sensuality, playfulness, and emotions. When we see life through the prism of Swadhisthana, we make love. And we play, we make love to ourselves, to each other, to the entire creation. The quality of the center is yin, it's a feminine qualities. And the pair of Swadhisthana is ajna, which is intuition, and also it's center of subconsciousness. So diving deep into our ocean of emotions through Swadhisthana opens the door to our subconscious behaviors and subconscious beliefs, to the vast, deep, cosmic ocean of subconscious world. The symbol of Swadhisthana is the sea monster or the crocodile, and it represents those sometimes not so pleasant emotions like fear, deep-rooted fear and regrets that we often don't want to face. But the only way to get rid of that fear that sometimes rule our decisions in life is to really feel it, is to face it and feel it. If we suppress those monsters, then in our second chakra, in our emotional world, which also connect to subconsciousness, then those monsters rule us without us even knowing about that. So the meditation and connection to Swadhisthana helps you to address and gently release those deep-seated emotions that we and beliefs about ourselves, which we sometimes acquired in deep childhood. So it can be a very healing process. Goddess speaks in languages of emotion. So naturally women are more connected to that center, and they can be wonderful guides to men if women are not afraid to connect to the depth of their emotional existence themselves. In terms of traditional Chinese medicine, the second chakra is the magical cauldron where jing, the essence, is transformed into qi, pure energy, and the qi fuels the higher chakras. So both Mulatara and Swadhisthana are huge reservoirs of energy, just like the earth and the water is life-giving essence of all life created in this existence here. Also, some teachers I've heard say that it's impossible for impotent person or person whose second chakra is blocked to reach enlightenment. And it's because it's the sexual energy that fuels the higher chakras. So in practice of celibacy, the sexual energy is not suppressed. It's cultivated and it's brought upwards instead of being spent through the for the purpose of just physical creativity, it's brought up and fuels the third eye in the crown chakra. Physiologically, second chakra controls the function of reproductive system and urinary system, so imbalances of the chakra will cause a disease of the system, of that systems, and also it controls the production of sex hormones, which in turn are source of longevity and internal strength. So truly, Swadhisthana is the fountain of youth. So physiologically, as soon as the body decides that it cannot reproduce anymore, it begins dying. As soon as it doesn't have the signals from the hormones, it can reproduce and be sexually active. It signals that's it. This physical body is no longer useful for natural purposes. So to stay young and active, it's very important to be connected to a healthy sexual functions. The subtle form of water principle is amrita, of the deathless substance. And in the body, it corresponds to blood and sexual fluids. And they say that sexual fluids is distilled from interspinal fluid, and it fuels, it's the most essential fluid in our body. So when you meditate on Swadhisthana, connect to the fluid yourself, connect it to your internal fluidity of your energy, and connect to the flow of universal energy that goes through you and in you and from out and circulating everywhere. And so you can really connect to the entire existence through that effortless flow, the flow of abundance, the flow of love. Create the space within you for that flow to come in, because if you don't have enough space, then that energy, that abundance of health, beauty, whatever you want, it cannot come in. So the essence of Swadhisthana magic is to create a space and let the inflow in without any resistance. The mantra of the bija mantra of Swadhisthana chakra is vam, vam. So you would sing it with a long V, vam. The letter V, or the sound V or Va, has a specific meaning in the early Semitic languages and Phoenician, which gave rise to Greek and Slavic languages. And that sound means house. It's the house of our existence. And interestingly enough, in Sanskrit, the word Swadhisthana is made out of two words, sva, which means your own, and adhisthana, which means abode or seat. So it's very much like a house. So it's your primal seat of your being. You can find a lot more information about Swadhisthana Center and healing practices for Swadhisthana Center and all the organs and systems which it regulates in my book, which is called The Centers of the Selves. You can download it from elementaltherapy.org. Thank you for watching. Now I will show you the practice, the basic practice, pranayama, the breathing for the center, mudras, and the mantra practice. It's practice time. So the mudra, or the finger gesture, for the Swadhisthana chakra is the circle, or the womb, where the seed lies. It's a space in which you invite anything or anyone your sacred space, your sacred space that's within you. And you hold the muladhara, you hold the mudra at, right at your center, at your water center, it's Swadhisthana center in the middle of the belly right here. The breathing of the pranayama for the center is exhale, and as you exhale slowly, you contract your belly and you contract your pelvic floor. So, and when you inhale, you just let the muscles open up. So you push your belly out and you push your pelvic floor out as if you were about to go to the bathroom. Complete expansion. And then complete contraction. So let's practice it slowly. Contract. Don't forget about the pelvic floor. This breathing will truly heal your lower abdomen, any disorders that's connected with the urethral system, the urinary system, the reproductive system. It stimulates the reproductive system for both men and women. Now the sound, the mantra is VAM. And when we exhale, contract, inhale or next exhale, we will sing slowly contract everything. Expand. Hold. Let the mantra VAM vibrate in your flesh, in your muscles, in your blood, and stimulate all that has most of the water in you, including your brain tissue. You remember how LAM should vibrate in your bones? Well, VAM vibrates in your flesh. And I think that instrument that corresponds and does the best job for stimulating that type of vibration in your body is didgeridoo. So if you want to heal your Swadhisthana, learn how to play didgeridoo. Or is it a vagina? You decide.